Good morning, Dad.
Hey, good morning.
So I have three questions for you today, and two of them come from our Ask the Expert page on our website. So I definitely wanted to make sure that you answered them so that I can get back to them, because I'm the one checking these emails. People are waiting, yes. Okay, the first one, interesting question. This person is writing into us saying, I was told my coil in my AC unit needs to be replaced. I talked to Lennox. They said it should be repairable. Is it possible to repair an AC coil? So she's probably being told by maybe a technician to replace it. She calls the manufacturer. They're saying that it can be repaired. Can you actually repair a coil, or should you replace it?
Know that all things are possible, and yes, you can repair anything, but you have to kind of make the assessment of, does it make sense to repair it? And it really depends on, where is it leaking? You know, how's it leaking? I can think of, over time, for instance, a Lennox coil, and every brand is unique, but can have areas of weakness that tend to leak, you know, so many times you know exactly where to go to look for a leak on a particular coil. If it's one of those leaks that you know history tells you that it leaks here, it typically leaks multiple areas that are similar on that coil, a certain type of joint, for instance, on that coil. And understand, we also are talking about, today we have aluminum coils, much more difficult to repair. Personally, I've not attempted a repair on an aluminum coil. Copper coils, yes, you can, but you have to know, does it make sense? You know, one, the type of leak I like is when something has happened. For instance, a line might have rubbed up against another line and vibration caused a line to break or something like that. Something that I can look at and know that once I repair it, okay, this is not going to happen again. I feel much better about it. But so it just depends. The other thing is, it's much more expensive. It's much more labor intensive in today's world, the way we have to handle refrigerant, the way we're restricted in how we handle refrigerant, just adds time to the repair. So you've got to weigh what's that going to cost, you know, the cost of that repair, also into what's the rest of the system look like. Mm-hmm. Does it make sense to invest this kind of money in a repair that, oh, there's other problems almost just as severe as this leak that we're not addressing at all? So what's the general condition of the whole system? Does it make sense or not? So was that a good no answer, or was there an answer in there somewhere?
I think that that makes sense. I mean, yes, it can be repaired. Does it make sense? You know, so
yes.
Which would be best, to talk to the technician? You know, the technician probably can tell you the answers to the questions that you just brought up.
But certainly when I check a coil and it has multiple leaks, it's almost that's a red flag, because if I fix these two or three leaks, what's going to happen by next year? It's going to be a different two or three leaks in it, you know, because of the type of coil that it is, things like that. So there is no yes, no right, wrong answer. Every situation is different, but you want to have a technician that you trust, has enough experience that he's seen those things. He knows that, okay, I would or would not want to invest money repairing this particular coil or not. So.
Okay, cool. Second question from our Ask the Expert page on our website. Our first floor is much warmer than our second floor of our house with the AC on. I know warm air rises, so it should be the other way around. What could be causing this? Thank you.
And that's true. That typically is what, you know, the warm air is going to typically rise to the upper floors. And most people, if they're listening to this, have a multi-story house, they're shaking their head yes, if that is the case. Sure. It is unusual that she's got a cool downstairs. So that kind of tells me that I bet you've got some dampers that you need to investigate. There are dampers in the ductwork. We've talked about this a lot, that they very easily could be adjusted so it's taking all the air that's going downstairs, which in the winter time, that forced air system, the warm air naturally wants to rise to the upper levels. And many times you can turn off the air upstairs or close to it in the winter, because the warm air is naturally going to rise, and you introduce all the manufactured warm air, you introduce it in the lower level. So I have a feeling they've got some dampers that need to be adjusted so they can get airflow to the upstairs.
Just go down to the description and you'll get a link to a video that shows you where to find your dampers and how to adjust them.
One other long shot would be, is I am picturing a house where the second floor duct goes straight up through a chase or something through the house, and there's a designated duct going upstairs to the second floor. Typically goes up into the attic space. Did something catastrophic happen to the ductwork up there? Did a joint get pulled loose? Did a critter get in there and cause damage? Or did something get smashed? Sometimes the plumber was up in the attic last fall and maybe something got stepped on, got crunched or something like that. So I'd also be curious about, do we have some damage or something to the duct that's feeding that upstairs that's saying, no, we're not getting airflow up there.
Okay, third question. This person is saying their unit is pretty old. Their air conditioner unit is pretty old. I had to get new refrigerant added last year, and it looks like that only worked through the summer. If I run the AC outside part of the unit that disperses the coolant, it ices over.
And that's kind of a general symptom of running low on refrigerant again. You know, so they've got a system where they know there's a leak somewhere because refrigerant doesn't go bad or get stale. It leaks out. If you ever need to add refrigerant to a system, be it your car or your home central unit, it has leaked out. It sounds like that is a very common symptom of a unit running short of refrigerant is icing over, because we never want to see ice on your air conditioner. So she's describing a unit that is, again, running short of refrigerant.
Okay. So call the technician. Okay. Well, thanks so much, Dad. Anything interesting happening over at 1 hour this week?
Yes. One interesting thing during this week, we're here in the Midwest, so temperature started to climb here this last week. Got a call from a family member, had no air conditioning at their lake house. So,
wasn't
just around the corner. So we loaded up the mini and went on a field trip.
Impromptu lake trip visit.
Yeah. So I'm not really a service technician, so limited parts, just a few. That's always a challenge. You're going out into rural Missouri with what I got. Can I make this air conditioner?
Was your brother like, hey, why did you only bring a picnic basket with a pool floaty? Well, did you get him fixed up?
We did. Yes, we did.
The lake will be cool again.
The lake house is cool.
All right. Thanks, Dan.
Okay. Bye-bye.